Hello students of standard 10. Today you are going to learn the same chapter, chapter 5, water resources part 2. In this part 2 you are going to learn about irrigation. What do you mean by irrigation? Irrigation is the artificial application of water to land. As you know, India is an agricultural country. 70% people are dependent on agriculture for their food, for their life. The population of India is also increasing day by day. To support this very high densely populated country, agricultural products should be increased. To increase high yield of different crops, farmers need to use fertilizers. They have to use hybrid variety of seeds, and for that there should be adequate water. By rainfall, different parts of India receives rainfall, but that is not enough to grow different crops throughout the year. And therefore, agriculture to cultivate many crops to support this very high densely populated country, irrigation is needed to get high yield. So though India receives rainfall, very good rainfall by the monsoons, but it needs irrigation. Why? What are the reasons India needs irrigation? First of all, seasonal rainfall. Because of seasonal rainfall, India needs irrigation. There is monsoon season, southwest monsoon season, which brings very good rainfall to the different parts of India. But it lasts only for 4 months, June to September, and rest of the months are dry. So during these periods, to grow crops, it is very, very important for irrigation. Second, uncertain rainfall. With seasonal rainfall India receives, that is uncertain. Sometimes it reaches to India early, arrival becomes early, sometimes late. So due to this uncertainty, the farmers of India are not able to cultivate different crops and timely in every part of the country. And therefore, this uncertain rainfall is also a problem for agriculture. Third is uneven distribution of rainfall. With seasonal rainfall India receives, that is unevenly distributed. Northeastern part, northern part receives very heavy rainfall, and the western coastal areas receive very heavy rainfall, and other parts of India receive less rainfall, and some parts receive very less rainfall, that is the part of Rajasthan. So in those areas where there is very less rainfall, irrigation facility should be there. So irrigation is very important. Next is the erratic rainfall. Which rainfall occurs in India, that is erratic in nature. Farmers can't trust on them or can't depend, and therefore it brings sometimes flood or sometimes drought conditions. And because of this erratic in nature, which is very difficult, where there is famine condition, irrigation is needed. Next is the cultivation of certain crops. Some crops need adequate water, enough water for cultivation, and the distribution of rainfall should be evenly distributed throughout the year, but it can't. And therefore, like rice, sugarcane, and jute, these need enough water, adequate water. For them, there should be irrigation facility. So, to grow these crops, India needs irrigation. Next is the hot climate. India lies in the tropical region and subtropical region. There is hot climate. There is high temperature. Therefore, because of very hot climate in summer season, the water bodies dry. And it is not possible to use the water bodies for irrigation. So, other means of irrigation like well or tube well irrigation is needed in the drier parts. Because of very hot climate, there is dry condition. Next is the Green Revolution program. When Green Revolution program started to be practiced in India, all over India, farmers started to utilize hybrid varieties of seed to grow crops. They started to utilize lot of artificial or chemical fertilizers. And where there is using of fertilizers, the area needs, or for agriculture, there should be adequate water. And that can be applied, or that can be possible only through the irrigation. So, these are some of the reasons India needs irrigation for its agriculture. There is high potentiality in India of irrigation. Why? There are some favorable factors. Because of that, there is high potential in India for irrigation. First of all, perennial rivers. There are many perennial rivers in the north, River Ganga and its tributaries. Also in south, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada, Tapi, all these rivers are perennial. And because of these perennial rivers, canal irrigation is possible in these regions. And therefore, these rivers are very important for irrigation. Second is the large well-level area. On the plain, Ganga plain or Indus Ganga plain, a large area is made of alluvial soil, which is very good and fertile. And this well-level land is very useful to cultivate many food crops and cash crops. And because of that, there is high potentiality of irrigation. And that is applied to grow in this plain area many crops throughout the year. Next is the reservoir of groundwater. There is high water table in the northern plain, and therefore underground water is utilized by wells and tube wells for irrigation to grow many crops and vegetables in northern plain, and that is very important, and there is high potentiality because of underground water, which is high. The level of water is high, and that is very useful for irrigation. Next is the sites for constructing dams. In peninsular India, there are many mountain ranges, plateaus, and smaller areas of plains. These ups and downs are very important because there are natural hollows, there are natural depressions and trenches. Because of that, there is very favorable site which helps in the construction of dams on different rivers, and therefore on river Krishna or river Godavari or Mahanadi, there are some important dams, and that is utilized for multi-purpose. So these are some of the important factors which are favoring India, and there is high potentiality of irrigation in India. So what you have studied, do remember. Thank you.